Morning, guys. It's nearly 11:30 and the parcel has been picked up, so I haven't got to sit around all day. It was quite early today, actually. It's quite good. I think he was here about half an hour ago to pick up the parcel, something like that. So that's that box of cars on its way. I left the battery on charge all night, which was actually fine. It hasn't overcharged it. So, let's go through the kitchen. Easier to show and explain than just explain. So, back one, this one, charged. So I've got this one back on charge. Try and bring that voltage up. This one was up to 10 point something volts when I checked it this morning as well, so that's doing okay. So I'm going to leave these two on charge and check them again in a couple of hours or so. But hopefully, fingers crossed, by this evening I can reassemble the battery pack, reassemble the controller and whatnot on the bike, and see if it works. Nemo's on his bed. His stroke my bed. That reminds me, I've just got to pop round to the shop to top up the electric meter. So I've just got this horrible feeling it's not going to last till morning. So, don't know what to do for the rest of the day now. There ain't a lot. Well, I suppose I can, so long as I remember, bring the hand pump up so I can get that bike sitting on inflated tyres. Sort the brakes out. I've got chains downstairs as well. If I remember, I'll bring those up. Just got to put a brake block in the back here. There's a rubber I fell off one. And I tried to tap this side up because I can't actually unbolt it. The bolt is just turning around inside there. And the rubber decided to fall off that one, so I've got to find a way to get that one off as well. I'm not sure how I'm going to do that yet. I'll cross that bridge later. But I would like to get a bit more work done on this. Bring my tape up so I can get the handlebars taped as well. Try and find a longer bit of outer as well. Not much longer. Just a little, it only needs to be a smidge longer. About that much longer, that's all. That's all I want. From there to my fingers. That should be plenty. If I can find... I think I put them all in that bag there. Did I? Oh, it's got the crank in it. Oh, they're under there. Excuse me, that was not pleasant. On a plus side as well, the electrician was here this morning. Don't know if he's fixed the outside light, but he was definitely playing with it. So we'll find out tonight if it actually works. If not, I'm just going to say bollocks to it. I can't be arsed with it anymore. Ow. Right. Even Facebook is quiet today. So, I'll slip some boots on. chuck these two tyres up in the cupboard out of the way. Ooh, I've got brake blocks in here, haven't I? They don't look too brilliant, though. I've got a box of them, which I think are actually in the shed as well. There's too many things to remember to bring up. I know I'm going to forget at least one. Actually, I've forgotten what it was already, pump. The hell was it? Pump? Chain. That was the other one. I don't know if they're the right chain in the shed, but I'll bring them up anyway. Because I can go in my pot of chains up here. Right. Shut the camera down, I suppose, and go get some shit did.
There's loads of you there, and the bloke on the phone as well. Let's have a big cheer.
Just had the radio on.
Okay. Are you ready for question number one?
Yeah.
Okay. Number one, Boss Hogg featured in which TV series?
Dukes of Hazzard.
Dukes of Hazzard.
Question number two. How many strings does a violin have?
Four.
Yeah, four.
Okay, question number three. What, you should get this as well. What farmyard... No, I haven't said... You haven't got them yet. I can't reveal the answers yet. Question three. What farmyard animal is traditionally used to search for truffles?
Pig.
That's a pig.
Pig, okay. Question four. On which river is Niagara Falls?
Not a clue. Mississippi?
You sure?
It was just a guess.
On which river?
Zambezi we're going for, we're not sure.
Zambezi?
Never even heard of that.
Okay, so on which river is Niagara Falls, you're saying Zambezi? Okay.
Yeah, we don't know.
And now it's time for the music round, so you've got to guess the song and the artist.
I can't remember.
Oh, just got it before they said the song. Who do you think that is?
I can't remember.
Sam Smith.
Yeah?
Love You Like I Can.
And who said that?
That was from Lee.
Hello, Lee. Quiet.
How many did I get right?
Back through the answers. Number one, you said Boss Hogg featured in which TV series? And you said Dukes of Hazzard. And the answer is...
Yay!
Oh, you're cheering now. That was the first one you got that right. Question number two, how many strings does a violin have? And you said... Four.
Glad I agreed with him, because I was going to say five.
Question number three, what farmyard animal is traditionally used to search for truffles? You said pig.
That was easy.
Three out of three so far. Question number four.
Almost upset with Mississippi, didn't I?
No. Oh, it was Niagara.
No.
Oh. That was the easy Niagara Falls. No, I haven't got it either. But there you go. So that one's wrong, I'm afraid. And the final one was the music one.
It's just a box of crap I brought back from Mum's ages ago. Oh, hello. Another one.
Correct, Lee, well done.
Oh.
One, two, three, four.
Well, not all of this has come from Mum's. Let me just turn the volume down. It's my spoke key. I've got no idea why it's in here. I completely forgot about that, actually. Not that I really use it. That's just a couple of old reflectors, spacer. I'm pretty certain that bracket was that something that was already here that fell in? Oh, I can't remember. Cables, another glue gun, brake lever, another bracket. Another bracket. Ah, that's a nice stem. I should have left that downstairs actually, because the box for that is downstairs. That can stay in here then. That can come out, that comes out, that comes out. More classic one. I went looking for the aluminium handlebar for my racer, which is currently out on the landing, only to realise it's still at Mum's. I only picked the steel bar up, not the aluminium one. Oopsie. Never mind, I'm sure one of these chains here will fit this. Because this is almost there, apart from the pedals. I can't actually remember where I put the pedals. I know I've got a loose one somewhere. And there's some on a crank somewhere as well that I was going to pinch. But I don't know where I put the crank. Oh, it's here somewhere, I'll find it later. Right, I've just been and put the electric on the meter. I actually had more on there than I thought. It would have lasted another 2 days, actually. Or at least till the end of sort of tomorrow, maybe Friday morning. But I thought I'd rather top the meter up or pay back the emergency that I used and have about, I think I've got £3 something worth of credit on the meter now. Which means when I put my £15 worth on tomorrow, I'm actually going to be, well, I'm going to have that on there. Because usually when I top the meter up on a Thursday, because I've had to hit emergency, I only get like 10, maybe 11 or 12 pounds worth of credit on there by the time the meter's taken back for the emergency that's been used. But this time, because I've topped it up already, and I've already got £3 worth of credit on there, I'm going to be £15 worth in credit, which is an excellent bonus. It's a good idea not to hit emergency unless you absolutely have to. Right. I've had these batteries on charge. I'm going to give them another probing. So I've just turned them off at the wall. Can't do it with the chargers running, otherwise you'll get the reading from the chargers and not the battery. So how are we doing down here? 10.6 volts in that one. And this one we've got 11.6 in this one. They're charging very slowly, but they are charging. I'm actually wondering if I should swap these two batteries around and see. Yeah, why not? Ah, that hurt. Be so much easier if I had another spade crimp, but I haven't got one now. Clip that one on there, clip that one on there, fire in the hole. So what charger actually pumping out the juice? The only reason I ask if that charger is pumping out the juice because the ammeter needle didn't move. Oops. Yep, we're charging. Yeah. Normally the amp meter registers with them. Anyway, I need to go and use the bathroom because I haven't done that yet, so do some more work on the racer in the lounge, and I'll be back later. Right, well, I'll just check these batteries again. We are almost there with this one. This is up to 12 volts. I want to get it up to 13 so it matches the one behind it. This one's, I don't know why, this charger seems to be slower at charging than that one. I mean, that's still 10 point some odd volts. So I think when I've got this one where I want it, if that one still hasn't budged much, then I'll try and we'll put that one back on this charger I need a couple of those clips. Because it's actually pretty good. It looks a state. Yeah. The charger does look a mess, but it works. Right, I was just watching one Lonely Farmer video, so I'm just going to pause that. Just picked up another vintage Chevy Capital Coupe. I'd love a little car like that. They look awesome. Anyway, I've had a bath. I need to pop to Sainsbury's to get something for tea. I've got eBay fees I need to pay tonight when my money goes in, as well as the phone bill. This now has brakes, at least, and a chain, and a gear cable attached. The only problem is the cranks don't match and they're not at the right angle to each other either, which is probably down to the fact they don't match. So finding a crank for this has been a pain in my backside. The only other option I've got, if I can't get a car crank to work, I'm going to have to put a single speed mountain bike crank on, which I've got in the shed. That's the only other option I've got. And the other issue, which I didn't notice, is that the freewheel doesn't freewheel. It's kind of a fixie bike at the minute, which is a bit of an issue. I don't know if I can free it up. I might be able to. If not, I'm going to have to throw the other back wheel into it. I've got another back wheel out on the landing, so that's not a problem. So, yeah. I want those batteries to charge so I can put the bike back together. I suppose I should put the controller unit back together at least. I might remember where the screws are. They're buried on there somewhere. Oh yeah, and those corners of the sticker that are all bent up to get to the screws, I'll just cut them off with a Stanley knife at angles like that. Just because it tidied it up. It looks a bit weird with the cut angles, but at least it looks better than the corners of a sticker flailing around everywhere. Alright, so I think later on I'll get this reassembled at least. Oops. So when I've got the battery pack done, I can just chuck it in here and see if we have life. I did find a switch. I wouldn't mind connecting an actual switch to it. And it did have crimps on it as well, so again, it's on that shelf somewhere. I might actually do that. Don't know if it'll be man enough to take it. There it is, just a... Hopefully those wires will connect onto that. I hope. Well, there'll only be one way to find out, won't there? But, yeah, if this can just get me by a test at least, then I can look into buying a proper switch. Because, well, as I said before, I don't want to go putting money into this if it's not going to work. If it doesn't work, then I don't know what the heck I'll do with it. Probably sell it as spares or repairs. Right, so that's going to be a nice little job. Of course, being a switch, it's not really going to matter which way I put the wires on. I've just got to figure out which way is open or which way is closed. Because I want the switch open. Was that really the time? 20 to 6. Bloody hell. Be interesting to see if that outside light comes on tonight. Right, so I better slip my boots on. Just loose changey on the floor. Oh, that reminds me, I've got to do a stop at Lidl as well just to grab a bottle of cola. Not unless I go and do my shopping at Lidl. Well, the problem is, I don't know what I want for dinner, so I don't know whether to go to Lidl or Sainsbury's. It would be easier to go to Lidl. I'll try that again. Lidl. Just for the fact I want a bottle of cola for tonight, because I don't think the bottle... Oh, fuck it. I've got some lemonade in there. I'll do till morning. Right. I did a rough measure up with the mudguard on this as well, and it will fit, but the mounts are wrong down here. Which means I'm going to have to find a different set of mudguards, that's all. And I'm not... I've got two pairs in the cupboard here, but I'm not sure if they're complete or not. But, you never know what's going to come in down the dump. Might find another racer down there that's worth only parts, so I could nick the parts off of it. I hope. That's what I'm hoping tomorrow. I don't just look for bikes that I can do up and sell on. I want bikes that I can break for parts as well, because I'm getting low on certain parts, to be honest. Gear shifters. I don't have a good selection of gear shifters. All mine are shit, basically. Usable, but shit. And I don't really want to put shit on a, you know, an absolute cracker of a bike. It doesn't matter if it's not a brilliant bike, you know, like the ones I've recently done up outside. If that makes sense, I'm not sure that it does. It makes sense in my mind, anyway. lovely sunset. St. Nicholas Church Tower. You know what I was actually going to do one night? I was actually going to go for a walk at night and take the camera. There it is, the ruined church tower. And if I remember rightly, that fell in the 1700s, but I can't remember what year. And all they were doing was bell ringing. I was ringing the bells in the tower and it collapsed. And if memory serves correctly, it did collapse a second time. The bottom part has all been restored and built into a room. Which I think my uncle helped to do that. But I think it was last year work was finished to... I'll just zoom in again. If you notice on the left there, you can see a point on the top. If I can just get my finger in, if it's going to work. This side. But not this side. That's because on the left side last year, they spent... I can't remember how much now. Was it 25,000 or 50,000? I think it was actually close to £50,000. Renovating the whole left side of the tower. Or right side, depending on which angle you look at it. Left side from this side. I do believe once they've got the cash again, they'll do the other side. But it was a case of not having much choice with the left side because there was chunks falling from it. They had warning signs and that 2 metre high fencing you get around building sites all around it to keep people away from it. That was up for a while before they started the renovation work. But, so I was told in school it's one of, actually I think it's the biggest church in Norfolk, I think, don't hold me to that, and one of the UK's largest church is, we've got several in town, we've got that one, there's another one just around the corner. There's another one on the way to the doctor's surgery, Catholic Church. Now, I have to say, that one, their car park is always full when they have a service. So, I guess we have a lot of Catholics in town. And then there's another one just... well, if you could go as the crow flies straight along, there's one just down the road. Oh, hello birdies. What birdies we got up in the tree? Hello birdies. They look like pidgeys. Oh, I've zoomed in too far. Where are you? There you are. Yeah, they're Pidgeys. Hello, Pidgey. There's one. I can see. I can actually see five. I'm zooming in, not out. Bear with me a second. Yeah, there's five, look. Five little Pidgeys. No, I can see another one. There's six. Oh no, twat, it's just his tail. Dumbass. You after the Pidgeys as well? Right. Well, I suppose it should be less chatty and decide what I want for dinner. What shall I get for dinner, cat? You don't care, yours is in a tin in the kitchen. What I hate about payday, I've got to pay the bills before I do anything else. Oh no, going the wrong way. You know, that's a bitch. Life's a bitch, though. Unfortunately, if I don't pay bills, I don't have... One, I don't have a roof. Two, I don't have electric. And three, I wouldn't have the internet, so... Unfortunately, I can't put off paying the phone bill any longer. That's going to have to be done. I'm surprised they haven't actually suspended me yet. eBay has put my account on hold, allegedly. Although I did manage to list earlier. I don't know how. Not with my account on hold, but never mind. Like I said, that can all be... But I think it's only about £7 my eBay fee is. Something smells nice standing here. I can smell someone's dinner. Right. So that's the plan of action. I don't actually think I'm going to get to do anything with these batteries until tomorrow night, though. Because I don't think they're going to be charged, or at least that bloody one isn't at the rate that's going. But that was the lowest. That was the flattest out of all three, for some reason. But it is taking a charge, and that's a good thing, it is taking a charge. I'm actually going to measure that one, now it's been standing, just to see... Actually, I'll do that now. I left the... fucking multimeter on again. Let's just have a look. Oh, it's dropped a smidge standing. Not a lot. Just a little bit. I suppose I could give it a little boosty charge if necessary. So long as there's over 12 volts in each of these, that should be enough to actually see if the bike works anyway. Yeah, I hope. If it works, I'll buy a proper charger for it and charge the thing properly. Anyway, I'm going to disappear, so see you later. I had that switch earlier, didn't I? Now I can't find it. What the fuck have I done with it? Oh, look at this, look at this, look at this. We can see outside, the light is working. I reckon they got it fixed just to stop me nagging. But sometimes if you don't nag, you don't get things done for you. So sometimes it does pay to be a pain in the ass. What have I done with that fucking switch? I didn't leave it in the kitchen, did I? Well, with that one, we've got about just over half a volt to go before I'll be happy. I've left the meter on again. I've got a friggin' habit of doing that. I don't know how far off we are with that one. I haven't done that one yet. But I've done that one, I mean measured it. I just measured that one. I don't know what I'm looking for, I just can't find it. I decided on... some ready meals for dinner. I went and got some sweet and sour chicken and rice for a ready meal. I'm beginning to wish I actually got a curry because I didn't really enjoy it that much. Come on. I want to stick that friggin' switch in. Here it is. Found it. Oh. I'm not sure those wires are going to go on there, so I may have to opt for a connector block for a better connection, I think. I'm just going to find out. Where can I put you? I don't know. Let's sit here on the table, shall we? Let's turn the screen round so I can see what I'm doing. Bet these wires are going to be too thick to go into them. Oh, no, it has gone in. Right, so I'm going to take that off now. What I normally do is I don't have a proper crimping tool. This is a trick that I normally do. This is how I do ends on cables, brake cables. I get a pair of wire cutters and I go right to the very back of the cutters and then do exactly what I didn't want to do. Cut straight through it. Oops. I don't think I've got any more of those either. Yeah, that was my fault because I applied too much pressure. It's the only reason it did that. I don't want to really trim off any more wire because I'm short on wire as it is. But if I have to go and get some crimps in order to do this, then I don't mind. I suppose I can make up. Some wire as I go, can I? Right, in that case. These are cheapy crimps as well, so that probably don't help, but yeah. I don't understand it. It works on the brake cables and things. When I do the ends, I just go right to the back of the cutters and maybe it's because this is actually bigger. Right, so I'm just trying to think what I've got. I've only got pliers. That'd be all I've got. I suppose that's going to have to be a pair of pliers then. There we go. Well, I've got one on. I will need another one. So we'll just stick that one on there. Right, that's one. Unless I just wait until tomorrow and I go and get some. Because I could probably find a couple of these in Wilco's as well. It's probably going to cost me a bloody fortune. Just so I can lengthen the wire a little bit. Actually, I don't think I need to. I think I might just go and get some more of these spade crimps. Just so I can do that one and then go and connect it in. That wire's actually well and truly gripped in there anyway. I'm pretty certain, I don't have any more. I'm just trying to think. I might have, it's a very big mite somewhere. I'll have a look later on. Anyway. Light off now. It's a rather cold night tonight. That didn't sound healthy, did it? I don't really feel like doing bikes tonight. I might have a look in Wilco's and see if they've got any better switches as well, but that's my idea anyway. You know, just switch on off. Right. There was something else I was going to say and it's completely gone. Anyway. Jesus, battery really doesn't last long. Actually, what if I could find that 5-volt mains adapter? Because I was going to try that. I think the adapters for my G-Tech are 5-volt. The only problem is, I don't know where they are. Well, have I got a feeling it could be in here, or even down here on the floor. Well, there's a surprise, there's a bicycle light, torch. Oh look, another bicycle light. There's a phone charger. Batteries, cars. Is that it? That's got 5-volt written on it. What end has it got on it? Oh, I don't know, it's connected to a pair of speakers. Well, that might fit. Let's turn you around, let's open up the thingy. Does it fit the socket? Does it bollocks? It's too big. Oh, remembered. Oh, I know what speakers they are. Looky, looky, looky. It was over here before I had a tidy up. Oh dear. Yeah. Come here, Mr. Charger. Is that it? Oh, I found it. We can try this one then. Is that a smaller plug? I think so. I will just double check the voltage though. Wouldn't matter if it's a lower voltage, it would just take a lot longer to charge. That's too bloody big and all. G-Tech. 7.5 volts. I've got a Dell one that fits, but yeah, that's 5 volt as well. I just don't have a power cable out for it. Oh well, I'm going to charge the camera. Be back later. I'm so bored. I really am. I've just been playing GTA for I don't know how long, about an hour or so. I've just sort of given up for a little while. Well, I did come back to a thread on a local group where someone was mentioning about lorries using certain roads in town to get to the industrial estate that aren't really suitable for them. But the problem is that they are the only roads available that don't include going over, or going under, I should say, low bridges. And I did actually ask on there, rather stupidly, I must admit, it probably was a bit of a daft question. I should have known the answer. But I did ask, you know, why did they put our industrial estate where it currently is, knowing lorries will have to go under low bridges? And a lorry driver actually said, and why I didn't think of this, I don't know, but he said, lorries back then weren't as tall as they are nowadays, which is absolutely spot on. Although, there were some that did hit bridges. There is an old photo kicking around where a lorry carrying an excavator hit one of the bridges. I'm not going to get a good reading if I have that connected, am I? Is that a good thing that this is actually going down while I'm watching it? We are getting there though. Ooh, sparky. Hey. What's this doing? Are we getting anywhere? Well, it's bouncing between 10.88 and 10.89. Oh no, it's settled on 10.89 volts. It is. It's just taking its sweet friggin' time. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna leave this one to charge it. Next all. Once this one has hit the 13 volt mark, I'll take it off charge and I'll put. I might as well show you what I'm bloody talking about, that might help. Once this one's done, this one's nearly at 13 volts, almost. So when that hits it, I'll take this one off and put that charger on that battery, because that one just doesn't seem to cut it for some reason. That's taken a really, really, really long time. This one at the moment is charging them a lot faster. Don't want to forget to turn that bloody thing off again. I've got 6 volt plug-in adapters, so I could just whip something up, you know, to charge them 6 volt batteries. It wouldn't be difficult. Right. I don't actually know what the time is. Pardon. 10:30, so if I give that, I don't know, I'll check it again, maybe at 11:30, maybe 12, midnight, don't know, one or the other. I am bored, I'm bored out of my mind. My brother messaged me earlier, wants me to take my Windows 7 CD with me tomorrow when I go to Mum's, because he was given a laptop and he said it's so slow it's not possible to actually use it, so. And he wants it all refreshed and whatnot, so I can do that, not a problem. I may take an Ethernet cable with me as well, so I can get the drivers. Actually, I'll take a thingy, a doodah, a what's it. I'll think of the name in a minute. Memory stick. USB memory stick. Yeah, that's the one, a USB memory stick. Because there is a spare laptop at Mum's I usually jump on. So I could use that, or Mum's, or even Stepdad's, one or the other. You know, there's plenty of laptops there. Or even my brother's, if he's going to be there. Yeah, if I take that. Well, I don't think I'll even have to take that one, but. No, actually, I won't, because I know what's on that one. I'll take one of these. I'll stick this in either tonight or in the morning and just format it. And, solve that problem. I don't even feel like watching YouTube videos. I'm just bored out of my freaking mind. Anything on my Lego channel worth watching? No? No comments? Ooh, Lego City Walkaround. I can watch that in a little bit. Oh, for Pete's sake. Ooh. Oh, I messaged that guy that's selling that vintage computer. If I zoomed in, yeah, I had, I must have knocked it. I wonder why my face was so sort of filling the screen. My jaw's not hard, look, look how chubby it is. Anyway, that guy I found on eBay locally, well, I say locally, he's in Norwich. I'm about half an hour drive or more away, but not that far from Mum. He's the one selling that dot matrix printer the old computer and a few other bits that I've got my eyes on cheap. So I did message him and ask him if collection was okay, if I won. He said, yeah, collection's fine. So, well, it seems a bit pointless knowing that Mum is so close to the city and she goes up there Mondays and Tuesday when my brother can be asked to go to college at least. So, arranging collection shouldn't be an issue. Or we can collect it Sunday when I go over to Mum's for dinner. I don't mind slinging some fuel in the car. It's not a problem. Yeah, so that'll be good. If I can win that for 99p, that'd be the bargain of the century, wouldn't it? Well, so long as it actually works, but I suppose even if it doesn't for 99p, I can salvage parts from it. Sell the parts, you know, and make some money back that way. Don't know why he didn't think of doing that, actually. Unless it's because he can't test it. Well, that dot matrix printer, I'm hoping, if I can get it. I wouldn't be surprised if I'd have competition with that one, but I'm hoping it would probably plug into my Amstrad, because looking at the cable, it's the same cable. What connections have I got on this Sinclair? No, I think that's a different cable. No, look at that, that's a different cable, but yeah. Ow, I've got a feeling that dot matrix printer will go on the Amstrad. That's what I'm hoping. If not, I'll just find a little old computer like that that it will fit. So, yeah, fingers crossed. I'm going to be going out of my comfort zone to pick them up, though. Thanks to my autism, but who cares? You've got to come out of your comfort zone every night. Comfort zone? What the fuck's a comfort zone? You've got to come out of your comfort zone every now and again, haven't you? Besides, Mum's got a sat nav, so it shouldn't be hard to find their address. Got itchy head. Oh, I got psoriasis on my scalp, which don't help. Does it look like it's frosting over out there? It certainly feels like. I'm bloody cold tonight. Right. This thing I'll probably continue with Friday, maybe. Don't know. I know I've got to run a couple of bikes over to Cats, along with some wheels. But I can do that whenever. Oh dear. Right. I suppose I could do some Lego reviews if I cleared the bench. Oh dear. Right. I was going to get a Lego set as well when I got paid, but I've been looking on eBay and I think I'd rather buy some of the tiles I need to finish this off, or at least the floor. I've actually realised I've got to do a slight modification to the walls, but that doesn't matter. That does nay matter. Well, what you can see here is a little green gap, but what I can do is put some flat pieces like this, but wider, two studs wide, in that corner, or better yet, you can get the corner plates and just put those thin plates underneath the wall to raise the wall, and that way I can blend the curved corners in with the floor, and that'll look a lot better. I'll show you when I've got the bits. Or you check out the Lego channel, because I'll do updates on that. Oh, I've got a hella heartburn after eating that doodah.
You should get,
Where the fuck is my mind tonight? Sweet and sour chicken. Jesus. I don't know what speed my brain is in, but it ain't fast, is it? I don't think it's found fast gear yet. I mean, I was then going to come through here to do something, and I can't remember what the hell that was either. I'm doing well. Not. Now, put this wheel. It's not the best wheel in the world, but maybe I could actually swap. Because Kat said she'd probably paint the wheels anyway. Yeah, it could be a good way of salvaging them. Well, I know this has got stainless steel spokes in. No, actually, from the way they've gone, they look like alloy spokes. Dun dun dun. Maybe I could. No. I'll chuck that wheel in. It'll be just as easy. Stupid bloody bikes doing my head in. It's been such a pain in the ass. My car crank isn't really working out either. So I may have to go and find the other stupid crank I've got to put on there. Then I'll probably find that bastard won't fit. You're being a pain in the bleeding ass. You realise that, bike? Brakes work though, so it can stop. Can't actually go anywhere, but it can stop. Actually stops pretty well, to be honest. I'm going to have to get some mud guards on it somehow, aren't I? Because it just doesn't look right to me. Probably going to fit that as one of the tail lights on the bike. May make up a custom switch box for the lights. That would be interesting, wouldn't it? Or maybe my stepdad could, because he's working with plastics and perspex and whatnot at the moment. Making a algae skimmer. I don't know if he's actually got it up and running yet, but that's what he was making. You better not disappear offline, bitch. No. Someone else. He's got a bloody habit of doing that, just all. Gotta take that as well, so I can put my letter in there. You know, I've got a question here from the Department of Working Pensions, right? Which said I had to post a thing back by, I think it's the 28th of March. And I got a letter today saying, we still haven't received your questionnaire. Please return it as soon as possible. I'm thinking, the fucking 28th isn't here yet. Dipsticks. But yeah, Mum's done it for me, so all I've got to do, just put it in the envelope, which I'll take with me tomorrow, and bung it in a letterbox. I could take a pedal down the lane, actually, and put it in the letterbox from there. doing. It's getting dark on GTA.
Oh, here we go.
Right. I've got to call it quits for the video, I think. Hopefully, sometime soon, there'll be enough charge in those batteries to test this poxy bike. I'll get a proper charger. If I know the actual bike works, then I'll buy a proper charger for it. But like I said, I don't want to go forking out that much money on a charger, or even batteries if I had to. I don't know if it actually works or not. The batteries aren't getting too hot. Bricks. Heavy bricks. Right. Yeah, I'm going to call it quits. I'm going to clear this kitchen up again. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and all that stuff. And we'll talk to you again soon. Bye.